If you look at the geopolitical reality today, you see that tragically 70% of fatalities across the world in all conflicts, Muslims are involved, and the greatest number of victims are Muslims. The Islamic civilization is in a crisis, and I think that instead of having a military confrontation with every other civilization, the answer lies in a reformation.
Well, there you have the author and founder of the AHA Foundation, Ayaan Hirsi Ali. They're calling for a reformation within the religion of Islam to combat its ties to terrorism. Welcome back to America's Forum. I'm John Bachman, again filling in for J.D. Hayworth today. The terrorist threat around the world seems to be growing as nearly every week there's a new attack, some atrocity like the one we told you about in Kenya last week. The U.S. and other nations are trying to combat terror groups with military action, but according to our next guest, the U.S. is going about this the entirely wrong way. And joining us for an in-depth conversation on this is Tawfiq Hamid. He's a chair of Islamic radicalism at the Potomac Institute for Policy Studies and a longtime friend of Newsmax and a man who taught me a lot about the situation. Tawfiq, it's great to talk to you again.
Pleasure.
All right, you are the author of the book Inside Jihad, Understanding and Confronting Radical Islam. How do you even begin to do that when we have a situation that played out in Kenya last week where we had Christian students targeted by Muslims, and it's hard for people just not to throw up their hands and give up on the entire religion?
I believe you have to start somewhere and sometime. Like, you cannot just wait and watch what's happening without trying to intervene in this. And in human history, sometimes one single idea starts and it grew and it changed history. Now with technological advances, with the internet, we can make a difference. Like, let me give you a personal example of mine. I started a Facebook page for a modern Quran interpretation that tries to teach the violent text in a different way to bring a peaceful outcome at the end. It was not an easy job, I have to admit. However, ultimately, I have in 1.5 years more than 2 million followers and likes it or fans. So with technology, I believe that what needed to happen over 200 years, we can see it really in 20 years with the advances in technology. And that's why my whole mission is to fight terrorism in brainstan, in the brain, in the mind. And part of it is reformation, but certainly there are other parts that are needed as well.
But it seems like a losing battle when you look at all the ways that ISIS and other groups are using the internet to reach people here in the United States and in Europe. They are clearly winning this battle for hearts and minds right now in terms of electronics.
Absolutely. They create fear in societies. And in fact, their opponents, like what we have seen from the Iraqi army at some stage, they were so scared to the degree that they surrendered to ISIS. So ISIS uses technology effectively. We have the technology, but we are missing the content. And when I talk here about content, it's not only reformation or new interpretations for religion, but also to use effective deterrence for the radicals. A radical mindset, for them, it is a win-win-win situation. The first win, if they succeeded to be victorious on earth, they will implement their Sharia principles and they are winning or victorious. The second win, if they died for Allah, went to paradise, they will have these 72 virgins and all this, their imaginations. The third win for them, if they were caught by Western societies, they will be protected by our human rights values. So for them, they have no deterrent. In fact, death, which worked very well in World War II as a deterrent for the leaders of the Nazi and Japan back then, the death is not a deterrent for the Islamic radicals. They simply want to die. So you need to really use effective deterrent that works in their mind. And also you need to work at the mind level at every step, not only through reinterpretation of the Islamic text, but there are also ways to change the thinking traits that creates radicalism, like absolutism, judgmentalism. There are many other thinking traits that you can use, cognitive psychology in certain ways, and even optical illusions to start changing the thinking process that creates the radical. If you don't fight terrorism here in the brain, in the mind, then we will lose this war, because simply a young Muslim will decide at the moment to get a bomb and throw it on us.
Tawfiq, let me ask you this question too, because you know, if you look at a circle and this is people who follow the Muslim faith, and then you have a very tiny little pin the size of a pin, which is Salafism, the number of people that practice that type of Islam years ago. But somehow that has become what the world recognizes, or at least here in this country, that's what the United States recognizes as the Muslim faith. How did it get so perverted, and why do you not hear more moderate Muslims in this country raising their voices in unity, fighting back against this type of perversion of the faith?
Look, currently Muslims are in a difficult situation because the Salafists are the ones who control the theology for years. For example, a rule like the Ridd law, which is killing apostates or stoning of women or declaring wars on non-Muslims and offering them Islam or jizya, a humiliating tax, or to kill them. All this is in the standard mainstream teaching. That is the problem. And Muslims are moderate because they simply, or moderate Muslims are simply moderates because they do not practice these values. But they don't have a strong theology to counter the radical theology. And this is what I'm trying to help with. So Muslims for a long period of time, deeply, some of them may be objecting to this, but unable to criticize because they don't know how to criticize. They don't have the theological base to defend their value system. And that is a problem we noticed over years. There was a condition, what I called passive terrorism, which is the passive attitude of most Muslims against radicalism. Now I can tell you there is a beginning of change over the social media. If you follow the Arabic social media, for example, and the Arab media, especially in Egypt. In fact, the President Sisi was very clear when he said to the Islamic scholars, you need to change. So currently there is a battle. It's not unidirectional.
Yes, and President al-Sisi is a positive example of what more people in these nations in the Arab world need to be doing and talking about this. You know, and also there's examples of history when people have changed, have started movements, civil disobedience with Martin Luther King and Mahatma Gandhi. I think there would be a push, and maybe it would be successful if that would work in the Arab world.
And I'm actually starting a new center called the International Center for Countering Radicalism, IC4CR, International Center for Countering Radicalism, and its focus will be only to fight radicalism here in the brain, in the mind, using specific cognitive methods.
Well, we wish you well with that, Tawfiq, because we know it's a battle that you fought in your own mind and you were successful. And that's why we're always happy to have your insight and talk to you here on Newsmax TV and Newsmax.com. You see your book right there, Inside Jihad, author Tawfiq Hamid. Always great to talk to you, sir. All right, more to come here on America's Forum. We're going to come back. We're going to talk a little bit more about the situation with Iran. And also, we'll talk with former Ambassador Eric Javits about a new form of nuclear proliferation and why we should all be so concerned.